Good morning, class. So in the previous discussions, we have seen the flip-flops, where we have clock pulses also. Now we'll see the edge-triggered flip-flops. Okay. In the previous discussions, we have already seen that we have level-sensitive and edge-triggered flip-flops, right? In the previous sessions, we have seen this level sensitive or level based flip flops. Okay, now we have to see the edge triggered flip flops. That means the output is going to vary based upon the edge. That may be a positive edge or the negative edge. Output, if the clock pulse, if the clock pulse is varying from 0 to 1, for some flip-flops we can assign for the positive edge. If you assign positive edge, the output will be varied for the next positive edge detection of the clock pulse. Then only the output is going to vary there. So in the similar fashion for the negative edge triggered also. Okay, here we are taking an example of a simplified version of 7474 IC. Here we are naming as three flip-flops with names FF1, FF2, FF3. So these are nothing but the combinations of three latches, right? So that latch is what we have seen before, that is SB, RB, FF. Okay, SB, RB, FF. We have seen the previous discussion that switch button, reset button, flip flop. That is a basic AND gate based latch, right? AND gates based, sorry, NAND gate based latch. The same here we are using here. Okay. So that flip flop 3, FF3 is nothing but the what we have seen in the previous session. That is named, there we have named it as SDRB FF, right? Okay. So we can see the design model of this. Okay, this is the basic circuit diagram what we are willing to write the code for this. Okay, so see here, so you see here first ones. Okay, so the combination of all these three are nothing but the edge triggered flip flops. And here we use a clock pulse CP, okay, a square waveform clock pulse CP also for the, and we also have the input as D. Okay, so after writing the modules, we can see the general simulation and also the corresponding waveforms also. So far we have not seen the corresponding waveforms, but here we will see how the output is going to vary with respect to the input based upon the edge triggers. Okay, so since it is edge triggered, when what we want to say is one can see the output changes only at the positive edges of the clock. Let us assume that value of the input at a particular instant of time. So just this FF1 and FF2 are also similar to that SB, RB, FF, just with a simple modification. What we can see here, this is the switch button, reset button, FF. Okay, there we have used the NAND gate only. This is the NAND gate what we have used in the basic simple latch. In the gate level modeling too, we started here with a simple latch where we have two NAND gates. This is the NAND gate. This is the original figure. So far we have seen, for this original figure, we have seen the synthesized figures only. That means a AND gate followed by an inverter. That only we have seen. That is the synthesized one. This is the original figure of that particular simple latch. the same simple latches are here all used here also, but just a simple modification. So you can see we have given output up to here. Okay, this is the one. So for that is same. You see, for the same thing we have kept here, but inputs, you see, the output is coming from this one and we are giving it. Okay, that means the Q bar what we get here is given here of this thing. Okay, and also you can see we are giving the clock pulse to both the circuits. Okay, we are giving the clock pulse for the circuits. The rest is same, right? The rest all is same. And the one what we are getting, which is Q bar, we are fitting it back to the input for this. Okay, Q bar of this one, what we get at Q bar of this one is connected as an input to this, and the Q bar of this one, what we get here, will be given here. Okay, and you give the input here, D flip flop for this, D input for this, DFF2. Okay, you have to observe the changes, right? This is the basic one. It is given as it is. It is kept aside as it is, and the output what we get, one, that is Q bar, is given here. Okay, and the similar fashion here also the same thing. So, but here we are connecting to this. Okay, they are fitting back here. Just it is you can remember easily. Okay, how to connect one to one. Such a way it is forming an edge triggered flip flop. Okay, it's a edge triggered flip flop. We can see how to draw the circuit for this edge triggered flip flop and how to write the module, Verilog module for this. We can see here now. So module DFF gate new one CP DQ QB. Okay, these are the inputs and outputs, CP, CP, D, Q, and QB. Okay, those things, Q and QB. Okay, what are the inputs? D and CP are the inputs. D and CP are the inputs. What are the outputs? Q and Q bar. Okay, Q and Q bar are the outputs. Well and good. Then what about this wire SB and RB, and wire S and R? Okay, SB and RB and wire S and R. We'll see, we'll find. Generally we used to use S downward and R upward, right? Okay, S downward and R upward. In the previous figures always we have seen that. Based on that we have given SB and RB also. We'll see how we will use. And also we require the wires S comma R and SB comma R. That means these are the intermediate signals. These are the intermediate signals. This which will be fed back, fed here as inputs. Okay, so if you get some input, if we can also observe the intermediate inputs and outputs, intermediate inputs and outputs, those things we can see here. So we are assigning some signals to those. Okay, so we are calling for the flip-flop what we have used for previously. Okay, so we are giving SB RB FF DFF. This thing we have already seen here, SB RB DFF. Okay, so we have seen this one previously. This is which is mostly latch. Okay, SDRB FF. This string we can give as name dflip-flop FF1, where we get RB. RB is the output of that, and CB and S are the inputs. Okay. So this is the FF1. This is FF1. This is the SDRB. Okay. You can simply understand like this. What is this SBRB DFF? This one is related to, as we said, we used to use S in the downward and R in the upward. So we can analyze this. This is to form a D flip flop. This is for writing FF2. Okay, we have an input as D, and we also have a CPS, the one more input. Okay, so we have S and CP and RB. RB is the output what we get there. Next, SBRB FF1. This is FF2. Okay. This is the FF2. Sorry. This is the FF2. Okay. This is for the FF1. And finally, we can write for FF3. That is for this flip flop. What are the inputs for this FF3? S, R, Q, Q bar. Okay. So this, what we get here is the S. This is the S. This is the R. Okay. S and R, Q and Q bar. Right. Okay. That thing what we have written there. So don't get confused. Okay. I will repeat once again. Don't worry. So first we are writing for the total thing. So we want to write this for edge triggered flip flop, right? D flip flop gate, which is a new one. That means we are considering with the help of the edge triggered flip flop, where CP is the clock pulse. We also have D as an input and Q and Q bar as outputs. So these are the wires what we have, SB, RB and S and Q. This SB and RB are the outputs what we get at this stage, this particular stage. And here when we go for giving it, we consider it as S and R. S here and R here. S here and R here. That's the reason at the last why we have given S, R, Q, QB. Actually, we have to write the outputs first, then the inputs. But there we have to write actually Q, QB, S and R. So anyhow, that simulator is also accepting in the order of inputs followed by the outputs. So it is written like that. So this is to produce the, these two parts are to produce the outputs, right? At the intermediate outputs, SB and RB. Okay. Now this is the way how we write the test benches. Okay. So whatever the inputs we have, we write them as registers, so as D, CP. And what are the outputs, we write as bias, Q, QB. And this is the one we are calling, where we are calling with its name. For that we are writing the test bench. So initially we used to make as, so what are the inputs we have? We have D one input and clock pulse as one input. First we are assigning them to zeros. Next step, based on the time delays, we are varying the clock pulses. That means we are defining the clock pulse. So at the 0th position, it is at zero, and after two, it is in the zero for 2 seconds of time. And we are making the clock pulse one. Okay. After 2 seconds of time, we are making it zero. After 2 seconds of time, that means 2 units of time, we are making 1 0 1 0 1 0. So that means 1 0 1 0 1 0 means it is going to form a clock pulse, right? So we are here. This total thing is to define the clock pulse. and in the initial stage the value of d is made 0. Okay. Now what happens is after 3 units of time, okay, after 3 units of time from the starting onwards, we make the d as 1, and after 2 units of time we make d as, there is space between the both, okay, hash 2 space d is equal to 1, sorry, d is equal to 1. D here, what does it means? It is an 1 bit binary, that is, that value is 1. There is some space between the both. After 2 seconds or 2 units of time, the value of D is made 0. After some time, the value is made of D is 0. That means we are giving different combinations of, that means we are also defining here the value of D as a waveform. Okay. And generally we used to monitor everything with respect to the time. And we'll execute for some instance of time, say some 50, 40. If you are able to measure properly, then it's not a issue for us. Okay. We have to add all those. These two, and these all things. And we have to add these three, two, three, and all these things you have to add. And also then you have to decide this value. If you don't have that much time, you can directly give us some 40 or 50 or 60. By estimating, it has to be greater than this. Okay. So, this is the one SBRB FF DFF. For this, we are writing the program. Actually, we have to learn this one first. Okay, individually, that means here we have called SBRB FFDFF. SBRB FFDFF. And this FF1 is the temporary name what we have given there. Next, what is this one? SBRB FF1. What we have called this? SBRB FF1. And temporary name we have given as FF2. Okay, this thing, it is not a necessary for SBRB FF, we already had it. Okay, SBRB, we already had it, and temporary, with the temporary name we are calling, and we are giving the what are the inputs and outputs present at this position point of time. So what are these two programs? These two programs are for this one and this one. Okay, after writing these two programs, we are calling those to get inputs and finally to get the output. So just let me explain this. SBRB DFF. So we have inputs SB and RB. Okay. QB is the output. Where is the Q? Temporary output is Q. And here we are using NAND gates. Okay, two NAND gates to get Q and Q bar, SP and QB to get Q. Okay, these things we have already seen previously. The same gates we are using, just the names of the variables are we are varying only. Okay, we are getting Q from SP comma QB, and we are getting QB from RB comma Q. This thing you can remember, I think we have already seen those. Okay, for this. And for other one, SBRB FF1. This is also for this program is for this part. Okay. So generally we have seen these type of simulations so far. Now we have seen the original simulation waveform, output waveforms. Okay. So CP is the clock and D is the data, Q and Q bar are the outputs. Okay, at some particular point of time, so starting, okay, CP is 0, D is 0, okay, CP is 0, D is 0, the clock pulse, CP is 0 and D is 0, okay, So here we are considering with respect to the nanoseconds. This is the 10th nanosecond. Okay, this might be the 5th nanosecond. Each point indicates 1 nanosecond, right? 0 nanosecond, 1 nanosecond, 2 nanosecond, 3 nanoseconds, 4 nanoseconds and 5 nanoseconds. Okay, so here you consider now. 0th position, all things are CP is 0 and D is 0, so we can't define Q and Q bar. We can't define Q and Q bar. If at all any values exist in the previous one for Q and Q bar, the same thing will be executed at that particular point of time. So after 2 units of time, you see here, after this is the second unit point of time. Second, okay, we are considering as nanosecond. After 2 nanoseconds, what happened? The value of CP has raised to 1. After 2 nanoseconds, the value of CP has raised to 1. Okay. CP is raised to 1. Then D at that particular point of time, D is 0. D is 0. Automatically the value of Q is 0. And the negation of Q is Q bar, right? So it will be 1. It is well and good. Then that is now CP is at third point unit, at third unit of time. This is here, this is at the third unit of time. CP is 1. This is the third unit of time. CP is made, CP is at 1, and automatically the value of D, you see, at the third nanosecond. This is the positions. This is not making delays. These are the positions on the x-axis. Okay, the third point of unit of time. This is the made, D is made 1. You have to consider from here. At the third and in the from the initial, that is after 0, after third point, the third unit of that means from the 0, 3 units from the 0. 3 units, it is D is made 1. Here it is at initial, in the sense at the 0th position of time, D is 0. That is same thing is defined there, right? From 0 after 3 seconds, so 3 nanoseconds of time, it is 1. Okay, after that, after 2 seconds of time, that means this 3 plus 2, that is at 5th point unit of time, it is 1. At the 5th point unit of time, the value of D is 1. So meanwhile it is also made 1, right? So D is made 1 here. So 5th unit point of time is also, there is 1. Okay. So at 4th point of 4th unit, 4th nanosecond, 4th nanosecond, it is the CP is made 0. At the 4th, see here, this is the 4th, the CP is made 0. 4th nanosecond, CP is made 0. Do you get now? Just you have written this coding. You have written this coding to form these waveforms only, these two waveforms only. That is to define D and CP. And automatically, you can observe, automatically there will be variation in the Q and Q bar. Okay, based on this codings. So whatever the delay what you have mentioned here and here, based on that general simulation is this, and exact waveform simulation will be looking like this. Okay. So here we can see the synthesized circuit for this flip-flops. The total thing what we have done there. SPRP FF or DFF, the total thing. This is the sensor circuit, and this is the circuit for flip flop SPRP FF. That means we have for this and for this, we are seeing the sensor circuits here. This is one sensor circuit for SPRP FF DFF for this one. That is the down one, FF2. And this is for the FF1. This is for the FF1. And FF3 is the final one, which we have already previously used. Just with some changes. Okay. So we have delays. I will discuss this delays in the next class actually, which is very, very important. Why it is necessary means sometimes we require wantedly want to give this some amount of delay, or else sometimes due to the resistance values and capacitance values, the getting of input or getting of the final output is very much delayed. Okay, those things we can see in the next class. Okay.